When the homosexual is about. Let's take the case of Jimmy Barnes. Jimmy played baseball all afternoon, and he didn't feel like walking home, so he decided to thumb a ride. He'd done it 100 times before, and he didn't think anything was unusual when the driver struck up a friendly conversation. In fact, he seemed like a real nice guy. What Jimmy didn't know was that Ralph was sick, a sickness that was not visible like smallpox, but no less dangerous and contagious, a sickness of the mind. You see, Ralph was a homosexual, a person who demands an intimate relationship with members of their own sex. So no matter where you meet a stranger, be careful if they are too friendly, if they try to win your confidence too quickly, and if they become overly personal. One never knows when the homosexual is about. He may appear normal. Thank you.
our souls will be back. And we will rejoice in hell.
day but today.
Where's this fucking faggot? Fucking pussy, wait till I find his goddamn ass. Oh, the fucking pussy's gonna get it. Oh. Ah! Where the fuck is he? God damn it! Where the fuck did he go? Fucking pussy motherfucker! Ah! Fuck is he? This little fucking piece of shit. Yeah, I got something for you, pussy! Ah, you fucking pussy! I got something for you, you fucking faggot!
Fuck round two!
Yeah, I got some more for you, you fucking pussy!
What you doing there, Randy?
Shit.
Oh, you like that, bookworm?
That's what you get for studying all day, Randy.
Fuck you, you son of a bitch.
Ugh.
So, Randy. But again, I see.
I'm sorry, sir.
Less patriotic. Have a seat, buck up. We need to talk.
What do you mean?
Well, there seems to be a little problem with this project.
Oh. No!
Randy.
You!
Randy.
You!
Randy.
You!
Randy.
You did this!
Randy.
No,
Randy.
I did! No! No!
Sit down.
I know!
Sit down now. I hope you guys think you're funny. If I find out who's responsible for this, your ass is grass, and I'm the lawnmower. Hey, Ray. Go to the next, okay? We'll talk later. I'll go let him know what's going on down there.
Hey, Randy. Look, I'm really sorry, but I wanted to have some lunch.
Yeah! God!
Look on the bright side. He's still going to get some meat.
Look, I will not have my class to a circus by you goon.
She did this!
Principal's office, both of us. I heard that.
Please don't, God. Please don't. Please. Please don't. Please, I beg you. No, please don't.
What the fuck is your problem?
Don't touch me. I just teasing because I care.
Yeah, right.
Does there seem to be a problem, kids, or are you just procrastinating to get out of class?
No problem.
Alright. I won't tell anyone you were here. You won't tell anyone I wasn't here. Clean yourself up, man.
Okay, hi class. Welcome to... Today we will be discussing...
Listen, Randy, you better call me.
The picture I'll be waiting. ...of orientation. I call it... Wait. Sybil, what are you doing? You're late! Please, get in here! Don't make me count your 20! Today's study will be brief, since it's our first class, and we will be studying the symbol of the pentagram.
Thank you.
Fuck it.
I don't see anybody else lining up.
Is Sybil there?
This is her. Who's calling? Randy, I've been expecting you, silly. Did you get held up?
I guess you could say that. So, how's it going? Hey, Sybil, who's that?
Oh, it's just Susie. Don't worry, she likes to watch. Look. Meet me at 300 Elm Street. After 12. My drunk uncle will be out cold. We can have some kinky fun in the garage. Remember, after 12. And bring condoms.
Oh. Okay.
What a fucking loser. That was way too easy.
I know, really.
Emily's back in town.
I'll give her a call.
Tell her to bring the book.
I know I've seen a few hard years in my life, but I don't bite.
Heard you can do a lot worse.
Oh, no idea.
Hey, yeah. Ben, yet. Hey, Ben, lad. Don't mind me. You keep doing it with the town whore. And I'm real proud of you. Congratulations on becoming a man.
Somebody like that saying something about me and her while you go out on your wife?
Watch your mouth, Ben. You better not utter a word of this to Susie. Because I'm just going to go over to Mommy and Daddy's and let them know that their young man is diddling with the town toilet.
I'll knock you out where you stand. Friends.
They'll be here later. Don't worry. They like to watch. God, you're such a chicken shit, Randy. Come on, have some wine. Loosen up.
Well, I always did fancy myself a wine connoisseur. Source, at least.
Well, it's cheap shit, so that's more. Drink up. Do you like it?
It's a good year. You're such a good hostess. Well, here we are.
There you are. Fucking loser.
Randy, you fucking bitch! What the fuck?
Still so jumpy, Tom. No speech?
Yes.
Can you stand?
We have to escape.
Can you see them?
Mm-hmm.
All of them?
Clearing just over there. A few yards away is the church. If we can stand and we can run, we can get there and find some kind of solace. No, no. Wait till their guard is down. And then we'll make a run for it. Nod, shake your head my way or nod if yours. My way it has been. My way it has been.
Oh.
Your faces. So perfect. Just like the day they killed us. All so young and pure.
Emily, why do you cast your eyes down?
This is a new world. It's hard to adjust. I fear our old ways won't work here.
Work here? We have the power of Satan behind us! You whore!
Yes.
done.
Missed you at Violet's staff baby shower.
I vaguely remember having received some such invitation. But my time is very valuable. And frankly, I'm not inclined to attend such, shall we say, mundane, common, trite events such as baby showers. And if please excuse me, I have a class to teach.
Come in.
Excuse me, Miss Rogers. There are detectives outside. I think they're here to talk about what happened to Vi.
I think so, too. It's all right. I was expecting them in sooner or later. Please show them in.
Thank you, ma'am. Hello, Miss Rogers.
Good morning.
I'm Officer Dixon. This is Officer Haberle.
Officer.
Yeah. We're very sorry to intrude, but we must inquire into the death of your librarian, Violet Jones.
Of course. I'm glad you've all come. We're all just so shaken up about Violet. She was He was a very valued member of our community, and I just can't imagine how someone could... Anyway, anything I can do to help. Have you spoken to her father? He must be awfully distraught.
Yes, we've just come from his house. Pastor Jones is taking it very hard. In fact, we all seem to be impacted by this. It was a very heinous crime.
Yes, Sorry.
Yes. Yes, it was. But that's why we're here. To figure it out. Ms. Rogers, we believe someone at the school may have committed the crime.
No,
if there's anything or anyone you can think of.
I really can't believe anyone here could do something like that. Not one of my staff. And the students, I just can't imagine them being capable of such horrors.
Well, we have some suspects. Or rather, a suspect. You see, there were a few rituals that were found there. And we found some symbols around her body. Occult symbols. And there's a few classes that are being taught here that may...
Officers, I'm sorry, but I hope you aren't implying that Ms. Katz could have anything to do with this.
Ma'am, I'm sorry. These are things we need to look into.
Well...
We haven't quite gotten to the point of accusations just yet, but she is someone we're looking into. How much did you know about her, Ms. Rogers?
Well, just about everything I would presume that a principal should know. She's been a teacher as long as I've been principal here. Longer, in fact. Officers, I'm sorry. She can't be the one you're looking for. She's so old and frail. She's just not physically capable of doing something like this.
Ms. Rogers, are you aware that Renata Katz's mother was arrested and put into a mental institution when Renata Katz was just a teenager?
Well, no, but what does that have to do with it?
The reason for that is because Renata Katz was tortured and forcibly sterilized.
Oh my, I did not know that, sir.
Is Renata Katz here today?
Well... No, she called in sick today for, like, the first time in 5 or 6 years. Oh my gosh, that's why she didn't want to go to the baby shower.
Okay.
Oh my, I'm sorry, I just... Oh dear.
Well, I think we've learned all we need today. Okay, well, thank you, Ms. Rogers.
Yes,
thank
of course.
Very much. Thank you
for
everything. I really am sorry.
Thank you.
About everything.
What evils have we brought upon ourselves? It's not real.
Thank you.
Yeah, did you hear the gays are actually letting them back into the troops back in to lead the, you know, lead the kids and everything? Which is fine with me, man, but I'm gonna be pissed if I end up buying two sets of cookies now. Shit's expensive.
So, what are you saying there?
Well, I'm just saying, like, they gotta get a different hustle. They'll be stealing the shine off the Girl Scouts. So what do they sell, popcorn? Who the fuck wants popcorn?
Well, you think they're gonna just, like, have sprinkles on the brownies, or?
Well, yeah, but I mean, like, you gotta be thinking about marketing, too. Almond fudge.
I can't believe you're talking to me about this.
Major subject on my mind at the moment.
All right.
Hey, look, man, I got kids.
You worried that your kids are gonna...
No, I just don't want them hustling cookies.
Get them a sugar rush. That's not okay.
This is a shitty part of town, too, man.
This place creeps me the fuck out. I'll
always, always. It's a little shack over there. I need to clean this car out.
Yeah, when do I have to?
Officer Dixon, Officer Haberle. Miss Katz, are you there?
Come to the door, please. We need to speak to you.
Renata Katz.
I don't think they're home.
I don't think anybody's here. Let's look around the side. Let's go back.
We got blood.
What?
There's lights and candles all.
Oh man, great.
We gotta meet Pastor Jones in like 15 minutes.
Call this one in. Get a crime unit down here. Squads. All right, let's get over to Pastor Jones.
Yeah, this is Officer Dixon. We need a crime unit down here, 515. Iron.
Staff. No, we're up right now.
Yes.
Worry not, my sweets. I have taken care of Emily. She did not cherish the gifts that Satan has given us. Now let's tear into this pig.
Killers. She was so young, so innocent. She was my angel, given to me straight from God himself.
Pastor, I'm doing all that I can do. It's just that we don't have any evidence, nothing that we can come forward with. Not yet. But we will. I'm just gonna have to be patient and trust me.
There has to be something more you can do. Those unholy fucks destroyed my baby. Find them! Do something!
I'm a pastor. I'm doing all that I can do. I will find your daughter's killers, and I will bring them to justice. You just have to trust me.
Haverly. Pastor. I'm sorry, but we've got a young lady here who's going to speak to us about the case.
Pastor, I need to take this. I'm sorry. Everything will work out. It's all coming together, little by little.
Haverly, this is Susie. Says she knows something about the case. But she wanted to speak to us before she said anything.
Please have a seat.
Hi, Susie. Anything you can tell us would be most welcome. We'd certainly appreciate anything you have to offer. Please tell me what you know.
Well, I think I may have seen who took Miss Jones.
It's okay. You can talk to us.
It's all right.
It's safe in here. Nothing's gonna escape this room.
I was walking home late one night, and I saw someone standing in front of the car, and it was Randy Thatcher.
Randy Thatcher?
I saw Randy Thatcher.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure this is the person you saw?
Yes, we have classes together.
Susie, thank you for this. You have no idea how this kind of information can help us out. Really appreciate it.
Thanks, Susie. Appreciate that. Big help.
Anything to help.
Something off about her.
I agree. I don't think she's saying everything that she knows. Let's head down to the school and check into him. Let's go.
Get off of me, you creep!
Please. My daughter was murdered. My violent. I need to know what you told the officers. Please.
I'm not telling you anything. Don't you see these people are evil?
I'm a man of God. I'm Pastor Jones. No evil can harm me. I've got to know you. Please tell me. I can help you. I can protect you. I can save you.
Fine. I'll tell you what you want to know.
Friends, neighbors, my daughter has been taken from us, from my foul evil. Our new sister has informed me of a wicked entity roaming the streets.
Oh, wow, my God. Oh.
Witches, children of Satan himself, are in our midst. They took my daughter and ripped her baby from her womb.
What?
It fairly soon. All your children will join my daughter 6 feet in the ground. I've gathered you here to ask you to help me fight this battle against Satan.
Yes.
We must burn those witches to the ground.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
Hallelujah, brother.
Yes, my children, I can feel Satan. It's very pleased.
See those wretched horrors? See the mark of the beast upon their faces? Kill them! Kill them all! Satan. James, my grandson, my
my first born grandson.
You'll burn for this, you wretched whores of Babylon! Let's burn these witches!
Yeah!
Indeed, never felt so good, Lord.
Bust up the pass on fry.
But can you believe the disarray they found on Pearl's place? I'm not a mess, huh? I'm still shocked.
It was a damn disgrace. Those girls going around wearing all that awful black clothing all the time? Should have known it was them all along. Seriously, I had that Sybil girl in my office constantly causing problems for everybody.
I had Sybil and Susie in my class. Randy, too. They were normal kids. A little angry, but normal, all the same. I never expected this.
Hello? They were not normal kids. Freaks, all of them. Personally, I am so glad those religious freaks burned them.
Will you all just shut up? Bunch of cockroaches. You don't know the truth of anything. You're a bunch of sick pigs wallowing in other people's mud, wallowing in other people's leftovers. I'm sick of you!
It's Rogers. Are you okay?
Sorry, I lost myself for a bit there. I'm sorry. This has all been rather overwhelming for me. Shall we step into my office?
Have you? Rogers?
Yes.
I just wanted to give you some information that could affect your school. We found Miss Cat's body in the garage. Well, most of it anyway. We're still looking for the head.
Oh.
It seems like the girls kidnapped her after they killed Miss Jones. There's also a third culprit. We found fingerprints that don't match any of the girls. We'll be back tomorrow to interview the rest of the staff.
Miss Kent, I'm at a total loss for words. And they found fingerprints, you say?
Yes, we're running them now. Hopefully we'll get a match soon.
Yes, hopefully. Well, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to have to compose an address to my teachers about Ms. Katz, and I will let them know that you'll be back tomorrow as well.
Of course, Mr. Rogers.
Take the time.
If anything comes up at all, please don't hesitate to give us a call.
Of course.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mrs. Rogers.
Thank you.
Strange, don't you think?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, our teachers and students are dying, so.
I don't know, I don't like it.
Me either.
Yeah, hold on, this is the station.
Admiral.
What's the prince? They got a match.
Did they really? What is it?
Okay, thank you.
It's the principal. We're her fingerprints.
Oh, let's get back in there.
Ms. Rogers, we know it's you. Open up now.
Put down whatever weapon you might have. We're coming in.
Oh my God. Put your weapon down. Ms. Rogers, put him down.
Don't come near me.
Put your weapon down.
I will slice this swine to pieces. You rats can't hurt me. I'm protected by the sign of Satan.
Put it down.
I am the masked goddess. Those girls you all talk so callously about, they were my daughters! You killed them, you pigs, and now I'll kill all of you! Satan! Master, save me!
You will see. Satan will save me.
Damn, it's some crazy shit.
Hello, ma'am. We are from the church board. Have you heard of Jesus Christ?
Of course I have.
May we come inside?
Sure. Come in.
Students. I am Professor Katz. You're in Religious Studies 101.
Waiting eternity for you to be born.
Today's study will be brief since it's our first class, and we will be studying the symbol of the pentagram.
Pestilence, war,
specifically the pentagram theory of orientation. This was prevalent throughout the 19th century with occultists. The first orientation, I will draw. Had one point pointing upward towards heaven. This depicted the spirit, which presided over the four elements, which is what we call matter. Fire, earth, air, and water. To the 19th century occultists, this was a good thing. Now, the second orientation can be seen very quickly. I don't have to draw a thing. You can just flip this card, reverse it, and there you have it. This orientation has two points, both projecting heavenward, both, demonstrating triumph of the elements over spirit. This was considered evil and able to attract sinister forces because it overturned the proper order of things. It had two names. This was called the goat of lust and the goat of black magic. You could even draw the goat's head on here. The horns. The ears are there. And finally, the beard in the bottom. These horns of the goat were symbols of evil attacking heaven. And if you kept this orientation in your home, you could be liable to animosity and even fatality. This has been a short lecture because it's our first class, but I think I have done my duty as your professor of religious studies to enlighten you about the PTO, Pentagram Theory of Orientation. Now it's your choice to either, one, keep the orientation number one, the figure of the five-pointed star with the triangle at the top pointing heavenward towards the spirit. And we all know that heaven has all the answers. It's the seat of wisdom, right? Or you can flip it, reverse it, and risk everything. Risk attracting evil spirits, perversion into your home. Something as bad as homosexuality. And we all know that can lead to hell. Seriously. My personal opinion is that orientation one cannot be proven scientifically. Therefore, I don't keep it in my home. Reverse it. Orientation two can be proven scientifically because the elements, earth, fire, water, and air, can and do subjugate the human body and spirit. To quote the Bible, dust thou art, to dust thou shalt return. Thank you. Class dismissed. See you next Tuesday.